here we are with none other than the queen of the track, we can say, PT Usha with us. So ma'am, what is the feeling? This is the first time of yours in Guwahati, Assam?
Yeah, it's the first time for me. I'm coming to Guwahati. Even though you are organized to Safa 30 meet, I have not come. So this is the first time and I'm very happy.
And what is your, like, what have you seen? Like, you have met that you are here for the interstate athletics competition, and from where the Asian team also, the team for Asian Games will also be selected. Well, what are you looking up to? Like, what do you think will be happening in the next few days in this tournament?
I'm hoping that more athletes will qualify for the meet, and I hope that they'll do good performance here. And I'm just thrilling to watch qualifying more in athletic events.
Yeah. And we have seen that these athletes, they come out, there are a lot of talents even in the rural parts of the countries too. Like even in our state, there are a lot many talents in athletics, we can say, and the remote places also. So how do you think they can be brought out to the, so that they can participate in a national level competition and an international competition? Because although we find one PT Usha, or we can say one Hima Das, but there might be a lot more, but we are yet to discover those. So what do you think it can be done regarding those?
Actually, for that you have to see the grassroots level status to take some interest to give facilities for the grassroots level athletes. Like under 14 section athletes, they are not going to show good performance in early stage. For that you have to select some of the very good athletes from your state, different places, and keep them in a separate academy, and give them systematically, scientifically training, and at the same time they should go for studies also, and gradually it should be a long-term program now for athletes, and within 3 years they start doing well in the under 14 section, and then 16 section, and then women's section, and slowly they will become in the Asian level and the international level. That is what we are doing in our place in Kerala. After my retirement in athletics, I have started an academy there, and the same thing we are doing there. And so from there, Tinduluka had come in 800 meters, won gold in Asian Games, and she had finished 11th in the Olympics also, and coming up from there. Like that, it should be in every state and every part of the place.
Yeah, we should thank PT Usha ma'am for taking such an initiative, that you are taking out talents from the remote places and giving them a proper platform they actually need. So we also expect that this should be done also in our state, so that those talents which are hiding in those remote places in athletics, they can also come out. And ma'am, talking about this tournament, so what are your expectations? Like, we have Hima Das from Assam. So what expectations can be done, can we do from her?
Himata's performance very recently, it is very good, like 51.3 second in 400 meters and 23.22 second in 200 meters, an excellent performance. But for her 200, I think there won't be any competition here, but 400 maybe one more. I'm just thrilled and I'm very happy to see the 400 meters run, because it should be a very good competition here.
So what do you think, we can expect her in the Asian team, like from
100%, why not? She will be getting to the medals in Asian Games in relay.
So we can say we can expect a really good performance from Hima Das, yes, in the upcoming Asian Games tournament.
Yes, she had even Commonwealth, she had come in the finals and finished fifth. It means that Asian Games, 100%, she's a good chance of getting medals in the Asian Games. Competition will be very good here, and I think more qualification I am expecting here.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you so much.